Be back here celebrating 30 years.
Oh, man. I just showed you how time flies.
And
30 years. I mean, you guys getting old, I'm getting old. But this is a great opportunity to come back to my alma mater and especially see a bunch of old faces, be around my teammates, coaches, a lot of administration, people that gave me a great opportunity. I tell you guys I'm thankful and grateful. Honored, all the good things above. This is surely a blessing.
What's this place mean?
Oh, man, we had some good times in here. A lot of fun, fans, I'm pretty sure the fan base hasn't changed. They cheered us on, I'm pretty sure they do the same for these young guys today. So, again, it's great. It's great to be back.
What'd you think of your Bible?
It got it on point. I tell you, my kids, they love it. They love it. I mean, whoever did it did a great job. I can't speak for the rest of the guys, but they did a great job in my Bible.
Nick, what's it mean to spend time with Coach Henson?
You know, it's great memories, Coach Henson. We were all at dinner last night after the reception with just the players. We had our Coach Henson impersonations.
Do you guys ever get tired of watching Nick?
You know, we just—it's just wonderful. You know, Coach that pushed us, expected a lot from us on and off the court. And, Coach Henson means the world to me. Coach is all—he always called me, check on me, and see how I'm doing, and vice versa. It was a family. I said this last night. This is amongst all of us. We're family. Family to stay together.
You still working with the Magic?
Yeah. Actually, this is my 13th year in my position with the Orlando Magic. The way that I feel about my school, I feel the same way about the Orlando Magic. Great ownership. We lost our owner, Mr. Rich DeVos, a few months back. His sons are heading up the Magic, and nothing has changed. What the Magic stand for, on and off the court, it's still the same thing, the values. It's ran by a great family.
How often does somebody ask you about the shot that you made in Indiana?
You know, they asked about it, and I taunt the Hoosiers all the time about it, because I have a lot of Hoosier fans in Orlando, and one of the guys that worked, he's a producer for Fox Sports, which I work for, the team, Ty Easton. He's a Hoosier, and I taunt him all the time about it. He talks about the Illini, and I taunt him about the Hoosiers. So he comes up pretty often.
Can you take me back to the decision when you decided to go to the NBA and get the first pick?
Wow.
What was like for you then?
It was a lot led up to that. I'm pretty sure you guys don't know the whole story. And the main reason, the very main reason that I left school was my mom. My mom was in a car accident that almost killed her. And my parents had went separate ways at the time, so it was just me and my mom and my sister. And my mom needed help. And you know, I couldn't not stand by and not help my mom and my family. So that was the main reason. If that wouldn't have occurred, I would have been here my senior season. But my mom needed the help, so that was my main reason for entering my name in the draft.
Really, career-wise, it leads to the Magic, right?
Yeah.
It seems like, you know, being the first pick, they really appreciated you.
Being the first pick of an expansion team, that was a great opportunity. Playing the very first game in Central Florida, so there's a lot behind it. You know, I know a lot of guys go number one in the draft, but not many guys go number one in the franchise. So it's a difference.
You get a chance to watch Illinois very often?
Oh, yeah. I keep up with them. Trust me. I keep up with what's going on. I've been following them, you know, the streak and how the guys have progressed and the play has picked up on both ends of the floor. You know, I watched that Michigan State game. I watched the Wisconsin game. They could have had chances to win that game. So I've been keeping up with the team. You know, they have their peaks and valleys, but I think there's a lot of young guys here. You know, to keep them together and gain that experience, that maturity, that on the court experience. So I think we're going to be pretty good from here on out.
Right. So with your team, you had a lot of guys from Illinois that chose to come here and play for him. I would assume he made a big point of that. He wanted to come to Illinois to the state school. What does that mean to you? There's a young guy doing that.
Me having the opportunity to come here, you know, I had multiple choices. I could have chose any school in the country coming out of high school, but I wanted to stay home. My parents had a lot to do with me staying home. My mom, especially, this was where she wanted me to come. And another, I have to say this, and one of the reasons that I really chose the University of Illinois is because of Coach Collins. I mean, Coach Collins means the world to me. I can remember my freshman year looking up in the stands and the first college coach to ever see me play in high school was Coach Collins. And we maintained a great relationship from that point. You know, him and my dad had a great relationship. My mom she just had so many good things to say about Coach Collins. He just was a special guy, and I still feel the same way about him today as I did 30-some years ago. Nothing has changed. I still talk to Coach Collins, and he called and check on me. You know, Coach Collins called me Junior. Junior, you all right? And that was from day one. So Coach Collins has played the biggest part of Nick Anderson signing with the University of Illinois.
Who would you give?